Hi folks, welcome back. I have your latest market report, home prices, insights for the city of Toronto. My name is Santos Sessa with RE/MAX Premier. I'm almost afraid to tell you what's going on. You're hearing out there, is this sustainable? Folks, this is getting to be a really tricky business these days. Let's get right into the numbers here. So I'm talking about the city of Toronto only. This is for detached, and I'll get into the other home types after this. Broken down by week. So last week we sold 206. It's just 2 units more than the previous week. So let's just say it's the same. Of the 206, 41 sold at $2 million or more. Now 41 is a little bit less than the previous week, but it's a fairly respectable week as far as the luxury market goes. Average sold price did come down from the previous week at where it was before at $1,757,000. It's now sitting at $1,589,000. Now that's a huge drop from one week to the next, but let's take that into perspective. We had 52 the previous week sell at $2 million or more, which was like a quarter, 25% of all the sales. And I'm talking about the previous week, which shot the average sold price really high. So for it to come down, we're still sitting at record prices. I drew a line right across, basically at the 1.6 mark, and 1,600,000 is higher than most of the year. So it's not like they came down, the detached prices, and all of a sudden, you could pick up a home for free. It's not like that at all. 1,589,000 is a really, really high average sold price for the city of Toronto. Looking at the same time a year ago, we're sitting at 8% higher than we were last year at the same time. Now, last year we sold 31 properties at $2 million or more. This year we sold 41, so that's going to help bring up the average sold price. But that's not something to look at and think, oh, it's higher because we sold more luxury properties. Overall, prices are much higher, and some big numbers here, you know, 51%, 90%, 16%. This last week we're sitting at 8%. So if you bought a detached home last year, easy to say with confidence, it's worth more today than it was when you bought it a year ago. And if you're on the fence a year ago, you're paying more today. You're paying more from a few months ago. So prices are constantly going up. Looking at sales, let's take a closer look. Of the 206 that sold, 157 sold at list price or more. Now, if we go back just a few weeks, so 58% sold at list price or more, then 59%, then 66%, then 74%. Last week, 76% sold at list price or more. So every 4 homes being bought, 3 of them are being sold at list price or more. I made a little note here because I looked at that number and I went further into really what does that number show. Well, of the 157 that sold at list price or more, 23 of them sold between $300,000 and $400,000 over asking. I had to slow down when I said that, and I double checked those numbers. These are crazy numbers. And to have 23 sell at $300,000 to $400,000 over asking, this is the market we're in. It's just really crazy. Now, some of these prices are being put way too low, for sure, but it's the market and it's the competition factor that's out there right now that's making this happen. Listings, we're listing far more than what we were listing last year at this time, and it's been like this for a few weeks now. But look at months of inventory. Demand is so high, and there's just not enough supply to fill the demand. We're sitting at, for last week, 0.8 months of inventory. What's that? It's less than, it's around 3 weeks or so, a little bit over 3 weeks of inventory available. What that means is, if with all the listings right now, not the listings, but all the properties available for sale, so ones that haven't sold plus the new ones, at this given moment in time, and if we buy at the current rate, in 3 weeks and a bit, we'll be sold out. That's what's keeping prices high. That's what's keeping supply really, really low. And you know, there's different reasons for that. But average sold price at 1589 is still a record price. Looking at some of the other cities, City of Toronto, Vaughan, and Richmond Hill, average sold prices are pretty close. Well, for City of Toronto, Vaughan, they're very close. Sorry, the City of Toronto and Richmond Hill, very close. And Vaughan is sitting at $1,712,000 for average sold price for last week. I'm just going to summarize semis for you. So average sold price for semi has come down by $4,000, sitting at $1,324,000. That, when I say come down, don't even consider that as any kind of relief, because it came down by only $4,000. It's kind of hard to imagine it goes much higher than 1.3 where it is now. We're sitting at a month of inventory of 0.3. I had to put in some of my own extra notes into this chart here. So the sales for last week, we sold 84 semis. 91% sold at list price or more. That's almost all of them. So every single semi is, there's competition on. Of those 84, 19 sold between $300,000 and $600,000 over list price. How do you explain that? It's just crazy what's happening out there. Just picture yourself, you're a real estate agent. Somebody calls you and says, hey, I'm thinking of buying a semi. You go, oh, we're in for a battle. And that's, if you're looking to buy right now, you kind of got to have that in your head. You're looking to buy anything, there's competition. Now, no matter what market we're in, there's always competition. Whether there's an offer date or not, there's always competition. But there's like extreme competition right now. Sellers control the market. That doesn't mean you can't buy. But it's so important to have the right realtor in your corner, taking you into battle, making sure you don't overpay for a property, because for sure, there's people overpaying and you'll regret it later. We saw this a few years ago when the market changed, and we're going to see it again. So be careful. Make sure you're working with the right people. And if you're a seller in this market, any agent could sell your home. If you don't have the right agent, you are leaving money on the table. That's how it is out there. That's the market we're in. Okay, so a summary of townhouses. Average sold price is sitting at $1,154,000. Months of inventory sitting at 0.8. It's been like that for a while. As long as months of inventory stays down, average sold price keeps going up or stays high. Looking at condos as a summary, Richmond Hill condos last week, average of $584,000. Vaughan, $610,000. Toronto, prices are going up. They've been going up for a while, an average of $671,000. Let's take a closer look at Toronto condos. Sales dropped a little bit, and so did the amount of condos that sold at $1 million or more, sitting at 18. Still, very good number. Average sold price for weeks now has been going up slightly. We're last week sitting at $671,000. So $671,000, when we look at back in July and August, is just slightly under the highs that we had back then. But ever since middle of October, we've got the highest price right now for several months when it comes to condos. Compared to last year, we're much lower. We're 10% lower than last year's average sold price when it comes to condos in the City of Toronto. This year we sold 18 at $1 million or more. This time last year we sold 32 at $1 million or more. Looking at sales, so a few weeks back, well, we're selling much more than what we were selling last year. But looking at a few weeks back, 26% sold at list price or more, then 31%, then 41%, 43%. Last week we sold 54% of those sales were at list price or more. So you could feel the competition, the market heating up there a little bit. And we were looking at, as far as listings go, so we're buying more or we're selling more condos than last year. We are listing more condos than we did last year. Sales are up by quite a bit. Months of inventory, it's pretty low. We're sitting at 1.1 for last week. That helps us to understand, with months of inventory coming down, average sold price goes up. That's just how it works. It's supply and demand. Months of inventory helps us to understand supply and demand. And if there's just one slide you remember, if you're trying to get kind of a pulse as to what's happening, if you're on a game show and they said, just look at one slide that tells you what's going on out in the market and helps you to know kind of the feel of what's going on in the street, it's the months of inventory slide. Detached, 0.8. Semis, 0.3. That's like 10 days of inventory here. Towns, 0.8. Condos, 1.1. This helps you to understand how tight it is out there, how competitive it is out there, the Toronto market, and expanding outwards in all the other markets. But I'm talking about Toronto right now. It's super competitive. I keep repeating myself there. It's so important you're working with the right realtor. It's so important you have someone who's experienced and can guide you through. Look, it's difficult to buy. It's a competition, but it's possible. And if you're a seller, you're in charge, but you do it properly, you could really maximize on your sale. My name is Santos Essa with Remax Premier. Subscribe below. Check back in a couple of days. We've got the Vaughan and Richmond Hill market reports coming out. Be safe. Talk to you soon.